Welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is G. Mahendra Reddy. I am working as assistant professor at National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Hyderabad. Now we are going to discuss about the paper on tourism in India on module UNESCO World Heritage Sites in India. After the presentation, you'll be able to understand what exactly the World Heritage Site is, what is the importance of World Heritage Site, and what is the selection criteria that they follow for a different World Heritage Sites, how many World Heritage Sites are there in India, and what kind of World Heritage Sites are there, and where these World Heritage Sites located across the India. So these are the objectives of the presentation. So now we are going to discuss about what exactly the World Heritage is. The World Heritage is a place. It may be a cultural site or a natural site or mix of both culture and nature, consisting of the architectural value, the arts, art forms, and the buildings or any other monuments. When it comes to nature, we have different types of nature. It may be a biodiversity, maybe landscape. So generally these are the different culture and natural heritage sites they recognized throughout the world. So this particular World Heritage Site status will be given by the UNESCO in association with different organizations like ICOMOS and other like IUCN. So UNESCO is a United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization. So they have a special branch called World Heritage Convention or World Heritage Site. So they will give a special status for a World Heritage or any site to get World Heritage status. When it comes to culture, they have ICOMOS like related to conservation of culture, and they have International Union for Conservation of Nature. Like that, there are different organizations that they will involve in the selection criteria and the maintenance of the World Heritage Site. Let us go through what exactly the culture and what exactly the nature is. Like there are different definitions that we follow for a culture, but when it comes to the World Heritage Site, the UNESCO has given a specific definition. So that consists or that defines as the cultural heritage site refers to monuments, group of buildings and sites with historical or aesthetic or archaeological, social, scientific or ethnological or anthropological importance or a value. That means generally any site or any building that which is having a socio-anthropological value that will be considered under the cultural World Heritage Site. So when it comes to nature, they have given a definition like natural heritage refers to outstanding physical, biological and geological formations, habitats of the threatened species of animals and plants, which are having the scientific and conservation and aesthetic value. So that means whenever they consider nature, that could be a biodiversity in the form of plants or animals or may a particular geographical diversity in terms of like the river system or the water system, the land system of any particular region or a particular place. So these are the definitions which was given by the UNESCO on culture and nature. So apart from that culture and nature, so if they have both the mixed values like cultural heritage and natural heritage or the properties of nature and culture, then it will be called as the mixed World Heritage Site. When it comes to the profile of World Heritage Site, throughout the world there are 1031 sites listed and which are having both cultural and natural. Out of that, 802 sites are cultural sites and 197 sites are natural sites. And there are 32 sites which are having the mixed properties. According to the UNESCO's ranking, the majority of the sites are in a different places, like first China 48, Spain 44, and France 41, and India is having 32 World Heritage Sites. To include any particular World Heritage Site under the list of UNESCO, that should have the universal outstanding value, and they have given 10 criteria to meet that particular universal outstanding value, among which at least one criteria should be followed or should fulfill to get the World Heritage status, which was prescribed by the UNESCO. So as I mentioned that there are some 10 criteria which they have given, so that they should fulfill. So in that, the first criteria, it should represent a masterpiece of human creative genius. So that could be in terms of architecture, maybe that aesthetic value. So the second criteria is should exhibit an important interchange of human values over the span of time within a cultural area of the world on developments in architecture or maybe technology or maybe arts, maybe town planning, maybe landscape designing. So this comes under the second criteria. The third criteria has to be a unique or at least conceptual testimony to a cultural tradition or to a civilization of that particular place which is living or still continuing or maybe disappeared in the past. So that is the third criteria. The other criteria is that should be outstanding example of a particular type of building, particular type of architectural style, or maybe technological components that which involved the construction of a particular monument, and the landscape which illustrates the significant stage of the human history. So the fifth criteria is to be an outstanding example of traditional human settlement, land use or sea use, which is representative of a culture or maybe cultures, group of cultures, or a human interaction with the environment, especially when it has become vulnerable under the impact of irreversible change that happened in a recent time because of many impacts. Maybe the other criteria to be directly or indirectly tangibly associated with events or living traditions, with ideas or with beliefs, with artistic value or literary work of outstanding universal significance of a particular place or a particular community or a particular group. And the seventh criteria, to continue superlative natural phenomena or area of exceptional natural beauty and aesthetic importance of a particular site. And the other criteria may be outstanding example representing a major stages of Earth's history, including the record of life, significant ongoing geological process in the development of landforms or whatever the different natural forms, or significant geomorphological or physiomorphic features. The other criteria is to be outstanding example representing a significant ongoing ecological and biological process in the evolution and the development of terrestrial, freshwater, or coastal, and maybe a marine ecosystem and the communities along with that particular ecosystem, maybe a plants and animals or in general biodiversity. The other outstanding criteria is to be to contain the most important and significant natural habitat for in-situ conservation or biological diversity, including those containing the threatened species of a outstanding universal value of the point of view of the science or a conservation. So these were the 10 different criteria they follow for the selection of World Heritage Sites. So now we are going to discuss what exactly the importance, why should we conserve. So when we say World Heritage Site, there are multiple impacts with the development of World Heritage Sites. So World Heritage belongs to not particular region or a particular country. It belongs to the people of the world, all the member countries who are there in UNESCO. So they represent the World Heritage Site. For example, if there is some World Heritage Site in China that we can feel that is the universal, or it can be our property whenever you visit that particular site, that may be considered throughout the world, like wherever the World Heritage Site is there, that belongs to the people of all the countries. So that means we have an international understanding with the development of the World Heritage Site. And along with that, when it comes to the tourism, there is a huge impact on tourism development, vice versa, because of tourism development, there will be impact on the World Heritage Sites. For example, if we take the Indian World Heritage Sites, for example, Hampi. Hampi is one of the cultural heritage site which is located in Karnataka and which is having a multiple impact on the local communities. It is providing the revenue generation to the local people and to the government, to the other stakeholders like the travel agents, the tour operators, and the people who are living and providing the direct or indirect services to the tourist. And it is also a major economic generator along with the employment generation. So there are many communities in Hampi which are depending on tourism and having many other socio-cultural and environmental impact of that particular destinations. The environmental impacts like tourism is contributing for the conservation of nature, the wildlife, the biodiversity which is present in that particular site. So like this, there are many multiple impacts on the local communities where the World Heritage Site is located. So now we are going to discuss about the World Heritage Sites in general, like how many World Heritage Sites are there and what are the different types and where it is located and what is the famous or a popular component in that particular World Heritage Site that we are going to discuss. So as we mentioned that UNESCO is a major player in a recognition and continuation of the process, and in particular when it comes to India, we have an archaeological survey of India, which is in association with UNESCO. They are maintaining the cultural World Heritage Sites, especially the archaeological sites. So maybe when it comes to nature, there are multiple organizations like the majorly Department of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is a player that maintains these particular natural sites. So in India, we have recognized 32 World Heritage Sites, and India's first World Heritage Site was recognized in the year 1983 was the Agra Fort and the Ajanta Caves, which is there in Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. So out of 32 sites, 25 sites are cultural significance and the other 7 sites are having the natural significance. So that means there are 25 cultural World Heritage Sites and 7 natural World Heritage Sites. So now we will go individually on each site, like about the inscription or inscribed year and the location and accessibility. As we mentioned that Agra Fort is in Uttar Pradesh. It's located in Agra and it was built by Akbar. And this particular site was inscribed in the year 1982. And the nearest airport is New Delhi and the closest railway station is Agra railway station. So this particular place belongs to Agra or Uttar Pradesh, but it's close to capital city New Delhi. The other World Heritage Site is Ajanta Caves. This particular site is located in Aurangabad, which is Aurangabad district of the state of Maharashtra in India. This is one of the best example and finest example for a Buddhist paintings in the country. These particular paintings or murals shows sense from the Buddha's life and from the Jataka tales. It was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1983 and it is very accessible to the road transportation, air transportation and the rail transportation. The closest railway station and the airport is Aurangabad Airport, which is there in Maharashtra. And the other side is like a Buddhist monuments at Sanchi or a Sanchi World Heritage Site. So this particular World Heritage Site represents the Buddhist culture and belongs to or maybe dated back between 200 BC in Sanchi and which is there in Madhya Pradesh. And the stupa's main glory lies in its four stone toranas and its hemispherical shape. And this particular site was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1989. And this particular site is very close to the International Airport of Bhopal. And this particular site is visited by many Buddhist tourists, especially from South and Southeast Asia. And there are many other international tourists who are visiting this site. And completely different architecture in terms of culture is churches and conventions of Goa. So this particular site is representing a different, the colonial or a Dutch, different architectural styles. But if you compare with other heritage sites, majority of the World Heritage Sites are Hindu architecture or a Buddhist architecture, which represents the Indian culture. This particular site is different from the other sites. This particular site is located in Old Goa, and it was built by different people, like initially by Portuguese. This particular site is, or the churches are associated with the various congregations, including the Say Cathedral, the Church of Saint Francis of Assis, the Church of Escateno, and notably Basilica of Bom Jesus. And all these monuments together inscribed in the year 1986. Site is very accessible for different modes of transportation, like air and water transportation, even the road transportation. And it is also close to the airport Dabolina, which is there in Goa. And the other cultural World Heritage Site is Champanar Pavagadh Archaeological Park, which is located in Panchmahal district of Gujarat state. And this particular site was inscribed in the year 2004. And this is archaeological site is having studded with forts, palaces, tombs, temples, with basins of starting from Pavagadh Hill to Champanar city. And it reflects both Hindu and Islamic architectural styles, and that you can observe in different forms like forts, palaces. The closest airport is Ahmedabad Airport. Apart from that air transportation, there are like the road and rail transportation, which is a very popular archaeological site visited by the many archaeological and cultural tourists. The other very popular and which is located in the center of the city, that is the Victorious Terminal or a Victorious Memorial Terminal, is a now Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal. Like earlier it used to be called as a Victorious Terminal, which is located in Mumbai in the state of Maharashtra. And this particular monument has declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 2004. And this particular terminal was built over of almost 10 years, and it is one of the finest functional railway station building of the world even today. And it is used by more than 3 million people per day. So this is the most impressive example of the architectural style of the Victorian Gothic in India. And the location itself is a prominent, so it is well connected to all the different modes of transportation. Ellora Caves. This is also one of the oldest and the well-known World Heritage Site located in Aurangabad in the state of Maharashtra. These monuments are dating from 600 to 1000. These particular monuments are witness to the three great religions, namely Buddhism, Hinduism and Jainism, in the ancient India. The most popular and the finest of the Ellora group of rock cut caves is the magnificent Kailasanatha temple. And this particular site was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1983. this is very well accessible to the all the people, like different groups, and it is visited by most cultural tourists even today. And the closest airport is Aurangabad. The other caves is a World Heritage Site, that is the Elephanta Caves. Elephanta Caves are located in an island of Mumbai's eastern shore. It is close to the main city. It's almost 11 kilometers from the place. And this particular site belongs to the 6th century AD. This Elephanta Cave temple is one of the most impressive site in this particular monument. And it's a rocky cliff and dedicated to the Lord Shiva. And this particular site was inscribed in the list of World Heritage Site in the year 1987. And this particular site is visited by many people from different parts of the world, especially from north and northeastern countries. And the nearest airport is Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport, Mumbai. Fatehpur Sikri. Fatehpur Sikri is a World Heritage Site, belongs to the 16th century, and it was built by the Emperor Akbar with a memorial or with a victory of particular period, and it was the capital of the Mughal Emperor for almost 10 years. And the complex of monuments and temples, all in a uniform architecture style, including one of the largest mosques in India, that is Jama Masjid. And this particular site was inscribed under the heritage list of UNESCO in the year 1986. And the closest airport is Agra Airport. Something different in terms of the cultural value, that is the group of monuments at Mahabalipura. These monuments are located in Mahabalipuram. It's close to Chennai in the state of Third. And this particular site was founded by the Pallava kings, and it was carved out of the rock along with the Coromandel coast. So this particular, like a Tamil Nadu coast, is called as a Coromandel coast, and it belongs to like in between 7th and 8th centuries. And this particular site is a very unique, that is the speciality of the site is a shore temple, and it is having rathas, mandapas, and open air reliefs and other temples with thousands of sculptures which glorify the different like gods and goddesses with a special attraction of Lord Shiva. And it was inscribed as a World Heritage Site in the year 1984. And this is one of the best World Heritage Site in the state of Tamil Nadu, and which is close to the city of Chennai. The largest World Heritage Site in terms of size, Hampi World Heritage Site, which is located in Karnataka state on south bank of the Tungabhadra River. And Hampi was the capital for different rulers, especially the Krishna Devaraya kingdom for almost 200 years. This particular site is having more than 110 temples and different forms, and it is also blessed with the natural beauty, the rock formations, and it is also having the mythological significance. And it was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1986. The Tungabhadra River, which is having a magnificent view from the temple, and this particular site is visited by many foreign tourists, and they are staying from weeks to months in this particular World Heritage Site, which is contributing for the socio-economic development of that particular destinations and the communities living in around. The other popular World Heritage Site is that Great Living Chola Temple, which is at Tanjavur, or the Brihadeshwara Temple at Gangaikondeshwara, and the Airavasteshwara Temple at Darusaram. The Brihadeshwara Temple, or this particular site, was inscribed in the year 1987, and it was extended in the year 2004 to some other monuments. And the other popular World Heritage Site, or the second World Heritage Site in Karnataka, is the group of monuments of Pattadkal. And this particular site is visited by many international tourists, and it was inscribed in the World Heritage List in the year 1987. And it is very close to it's not exactly close, but this particular site is having the accessibility for a different modes of transportation, and the closest airport is Bangalore Airport. And the other architecture or the unique type of architecture is having that Humayun's Tomb. This is also one of the oldest World Heritage Site in the country. And this particular Tomb of Humayun, the second Mughal Emperor, which is located in Delhi, and it was built in the year 1565. And it is popular for the garden tomb and also inspiration for several later monuments like Taj Mahal. And it was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1993, and it is close to Indira Gandhi International Airport, Delhi. So the recently inscribed listed World Heritage Site is Hill Forts of Rajasthan. So that is having a group of monuments like six extensive and majestic hill forts together reflect the elaborate fortified seats of a power of a Rajput kings, and it was built between the 8th and 18th centuries. The six forts are situated in Chittagarh and Kumbalgarh, Swai Mother and Jalwar, Jaisalmer. So these are the different forts which was listed as a group of the forts of Rajasthan, and it was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 2013. Khajuraho group of monuments, this is also one of the best visited World Heritage Site and one of the oldest site, of course the earliest World Heritage Site, which is located in Madhya Pradesh and which is reflecting the Nagara style of architecture, and it's the symbolism for their erotic sculpture. Mahabodhi temple complex at Bodh Gaya. So this is a Buddhist site which was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 2002, and so it is fulfilling the World Heritage Site criteria 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. And this particular site is located in Bodh Gaya in the state of Bihar. So the other World Heritage Site is Mountain Railways of India. So this is one of the unique World Heritage Site that we are having in the country. Mountain Railways of India are the six lines built during the late 19th century, early 20th century of the colonial period, and which is reflecting the history of the railways or steam lines of that particular period. Today, the Indian Railway runs this particular site, especially for the tourist. We call like different names like Thai trains and all. Today, the Indian Railway runs them, and while four of these seven, the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, the Kalka-Shimla Railway, the Kangra Valley Railway, and Patankot, of course, in Uttarakhand, and the Kashmir Railway, or the one of the, like, recently got recognition and running the trains, the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, the Nilgiri Mountain Railways, and Kalka-Shimla Railway have collectively been designated as a World Heritage Site status for this unique continuation of this rail transportation system in the country. And the other World Heritage Site is that Qutub Minar, or a group of monuments at Qutub Minar. So this particular complex is an array of monuments and buildings located in the capital city of Delhi, and the iron pillar is one of the world's foremost metallurgical curiosities. The pillar is having 7.2 meters height, and it weighs more than 6 tons. Was originally erected by Chandragupta II Vikramaditya in the year 1993. It was declared as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So Rani Ka Wal, it is also one of the greatest example for the architectural and art reflection that which is there in the this particular stepwell. It is located in a place called Patan in the state of Gujarat, and it is having a unique architectural value and reflecting the different gods and goddesses in the sculpture, in the form of sculpture. And this particular site was recognized as a World Heritage Site in the year 2014 by the UNESCO. And there are many places to be excavated and explored for the archaeological significance, because it was one of the greatest site in the past. Now there is a more scope and potential for the conservation and even for the excavation of this particular site in the form of like archaeological excavations. So another very popular World Heritage site is Red Fort Complex. So this particular site as a palace and the fort of Shahjahanabad, the new capital of the fifth Mughal Emperor of India, his name is Shahjahan, and it was constructed in 17th century. It is also known as Lal Qila because of its massive enclosing walls of red sandstone. And this particular site is located in Delhi on the river bank of Yamuna. And this particular site is having innovative planning and architectural style, including the garden design, strongly influenced the later buildings of gardens of the state of Rajasthan, Delhi, Agra and other areas. And this particular site was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 2007. The other example or unique example of the World Heritage Site, like which is having belongs to like very the oldest historical significance, that is Rock Shelters of Bhimbetka, and it is located just close to the Bhopal, and it was inscribed as a World Heritage Site in the year 2002, and this particular site was explored in the year 1957. And these are a group of five clusters of rock shelters with the paintings. So that which will belongs to or reflect to Mesolithic period culture right through the historic period. World Heritage Site in the state of Orissa is a Konark. This is a 13th century sun temple located in Konark in the state of Odisha. Taj Mahal, one of the icon of the country and which is very popular World Heritage Site throughout the world, and it is visited by many tourists from different parts of the world, and it is also one of the seven wonders of the world, and it is located in Agra in the state of Uttar Pradesh, and it was inscribed as a World Heritage Site in the year 1983. So the other World Heritage Site is Jantar Mantar. It is in the state of Jaipur, and it was listed under the World Heritage Site in the year 2010. So now we have discussed all the cultural heritage site. The next is about the natural heritage sites, so that which are having the natural significance in the country. So that is the Great Himalayan National Park Conservation Area is one of the recently inscribed World Heritage Site under the cultural heritage list. It is located in a Kullu region of Himachal Pradesh, and this particular park was established in the year 1984. It is at an altitude of between 1500 to 6000 meters. So it is inhabited to numerous flora and fauna. There are more than 375 species. So as I mentioned, this was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 2014. Kaziranga National Park is also one of the natural heritage site, national park and the World Heritage Site. This World Heritage status was given in the year 1985, and it is reflecting the rich biodiversity and located in the state of Assam. Kweledo National Park, or generally Bharatpur National Park they call it. This particular national park is located in a Bharatpur is in the state of Rajasthan, and this particular site was listed in the World Heritage Site status in the year 1985 for this natural and or the biological importance. And it is having more than 364 different species, and it is one of the best place for migratory birds of look in a large numbers from different places, like even from the countries like Afghanistan, Turkmenistan and China, Siberia. So the other World Heritage Site is the Manasa wildlife life sanctuary or Manasa World Heritage Site, and it is the Project Tiger Reserve site and Elephant Reserve, Biosphere Reserve. It is having a different status, and it is located in the state of Assam. It is very popular for the different wild animals and water buffalo and other any flora and fauna, and it is including many endangered species such as tigers and other animals. So this particular site was declared as a World Heritage Site in the year 1985 for its unique natural environment. So Nanda Devi Valley of Flowers or Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve is located in the state of Uttarakhand. This is also one of the beautiful natural world heritage site, which is having aesthetic value and the home for a different species and having very rich biodiversity. And this particular site was described as a World Heritage Site in the year 1988, and the area was extended to some nearby places in the year 2015, and which falls under the category of 7 and 10 criteria, and it is close to Dehradun Airport. Sundarbans is a national park and World Heritage Site located in West Bengal, and it is the mouth of the Ganges and Brahmaputra River between India and Bangladesh, and it is one of the world's longest and largest mangrove forest, which is having a biological value and aesthetic value, which is having unique ecosystem. And this particular site is also famous for the tigers, listed in the World Heritage Site in the year 1987 for its unique natural value. Western Ghats, again one of the largest area which got the World Heritage status in the year 2002. So this particular site is located in a group of states like Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, which is having a very largest area. And this particular site is considered as a hottest biodiversity hotspots, and it is having the national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and other reserve forest, and it was inscribed in the list of World Heritage status in the year 2012. So we have discussed about the natural and cultural heritage sites which are there in India. So with this, I would like to summarize that the World Heritage Site is one of the unique concept which was designed by the UNESCO and promoted by the member countries, and which is having the universal outstanding value of the cultural, natural or mixed properties of the culture and nature, and which was maintained by the different organizations of a particular site. And these sites are having socio-economic and environmental impact both on the destination and the sites, which are also generating income to the local people, employment to the local people, and revenue to the different stakeholders, and access to the government in a different ways. And it is also promoting the tourism of that particular place and the country. So World Heritage Sites are part of the heritage tourism. It may be cultural tourism or archaeological tourism. So generally it will be considered under heritage tourism in any particular region. So as I mentioned that, so this is a unique concept and having outstanding universal value and also having major socio-economic and environmental political impacts on a destination. So with this, I would like to close up. For more information, you please go through the quadrant 3 and 4, which is having the internet resources or a bibliographic resources that will give you more information or in detailed information about the World Heritage Sites or the process of the selection of World Heritage Site. Thank you.